got to win the game to the people who run it, to the people who own it, that unless you're free, the machine will be prevented from working at all, from working at all, from working at all.
Don't lay down and die because a new world order, the business of the day for the elite, when you're coming to take your freedoms.
Hello again, human beings from the planet Earth. It's time again for some more wonderful pot news. Before I get started, I want to give a shout out and thanks to YouTuber Ahmad Painter for his psychedelic pot background on what you see in front of you. Great artist, great guy. Check out his channel. I'll link you to that. I'll link you also to this post in the 2012 Awakening blog that I'm about to read. A study in the August edition of the Journal of School Health finds that the generations-old theory of a gateway drug effect is in fact accurate, but shifts the blame for escalating substance abuse away from marijuana and onto the most pervasive and socially accepted drug in American life, alcohol. Using a nationally representative sample from the University of Michigan's annual Monitoring the Future survey, the study blasts holes in drug war orthodoxy wide enough to drive a truck through, definitely proving that marijuana use is not the primary indicator of whether a person will move on to a more dangerous substance. By delaying the onset of alcohol initiation, rates of both licit substance abuse like tobacco and illicit substance abuse like marijuana and other drugs will be positively effective, and they will hopefully go down, study co-author Adam E. Berry, an assistant professor at the University of Florida's Department of Health Education and Behavior, told Raw Story in an exclusive interview. While Berry's study shows evidence that substance abuse behaviors can be predicted with a high degree of accuracy by examining a subject's drug history, he believes that the persistent and misguided notion of marijuana as the primary gateway to more harmful substances went awry because its creators, who called it the stepping stone hypothesis in the reefer madness era of the 1930s, fundamentally misread the data and failed to conduct an adequate follow-up. Some of these earlier iterations needed to be fleshed out, Berry said. That's why we wanted to study this. The latest form of the gateway theory is that it begins with marijuana and moves on finally to what lay people call harder drugs. As you can see from the findings of our study, it confirmed this gateway hypothesis, but it follows progression from licit substances, specifically alcohol, and moves on to illicit substances. So basically, if we know what someone says with regards to their alcohol use, then we should be able to predict what they respond to with other drugs, he explained. Another way to say this, if we know someone has done heroin, then we can assume that they have tried all the others. While that standardized progression certainly doesn't fit every single drug user, the study took that into account too. If there were a low enough number of errors that you were able to accurately predict future substance abuse behavior with about 92% accuracy, Berry said. By comparing substance abuse rates between drinkers and non-drinkers, they ultimately found that seniors in high school who had consumed alcohol at least once in their lives were 13 more times likely to use cigarettes, 16 times more likely to use marijuana and other narcotics, and 13 times more likely to use cocaine. Berry also noted that the rates of tobacco and marijuana use among all 12th grade high school students were virtually the same, confirming a report from the Center of Disease Control published in June and an analysis Raw Story published in May. The study should give pause to anyone involved in youth drug awareness programs, as its findings suggest that making science-based alcohol education a top priority could actually turn the tide of the drug war, but only if the lawmakers leading the educators decide to use the same science as a foundation for public policy and school curriculum. I think these results have to do with the level of access children have to alcohol, and that alcohol is viewed as less harmful in some of these other substances, Berry said. The post continues on. The social misconception, largely driven by the sheer popularity of alcohol and the profits it generates for private industry, is diametrically opposed to the most current science available on drug harms. A study published in 2010 in the medical journal Lancet ranked alcohol as the most harmful drug of all, above heroin, crack, meth, cocaine, and tobacco. Even more striking, the Lancet study found that harms to others near the user were more than double those of the second most harmful drug, heroin. So, in other words, people that are drunk are hurting people that are smoking pot are not. I'll break that down in simple terms for you. Link to the post will be below. There's some other links that you can pick up, these different studies they referred to, information that you should have. And I'll tell you from my experience, if it wasn't for marijuana, I probably would be a full-blown addict of all of the above on the drug list. I used to drink a lot, drug a lot, and I smoke pot on a regular basis. I'm mentally awake, very sharp, very active, very physically fit. And that's after 26 years of very consistent marijuana use. The study backs it up, my life history backs it up, and we need to free the trees. Well, that's the latest pot news update. Thanks everybody for listening. Links to A Mad Painter and the post that I read to you from will be below.